There are growing calls for improved road infrastructure and traffic management measures in Grenada, particularly in the southern parts of the island, where commuters face long delays due to slow-moving traffic. This has sparked concerns over the impact on national productivity. Many have pointed to the daily congestion as a result of ongoing work on the Woburn Cliff Road, sometimes as far back as the Marion-Calavini area, and along the Grand Anse Main Road as examples of significant impediment to business operations. The effects of the slow-moving traffic have extended beyond individual frustration, with business sector representative in the upper house, Salim Rahman, highlighting how the situation hampers productivity. The constant delays during peak hours are said to be causing lost work hours and increased transportation costs for businesses, affecting both the public and private sectors. Speaking on the issue, a concerned citizen notes that our roads are simply not designed to handle the volume of traffic we're seeing now, causing delays and making it harder for people to get to work on time. Stakeholders from various sectors have voiced their frustrations, emphasizing that without proper road improvements and traffic control measures, the current situation is unsustainable. Several recommendations have been made to alleviate the problem, including road widening projects, the construction of bypasses, and improved traffic signal systems. With over 60,000 vehicles on Grenada's roads and traffic congestion continuing to impede productivity, many agree that decisive action is needed. In May of this year, Prime Minister and Minister for Transportation Deacon Mitchell announced government's plans to embark on an initiative that will result in a reduction of the number of private vehicles for personal use on the roads, encouraging the use of public transportation. For GBN News, Nisha Paul.